Make sure you download the School Duel app on your smartphone so you can keep up to date with everything School Duel right at your fingertips. The School Duel app is available right now for all iPhone and Android users.
The following program is presented by Chick-fil-A and Bright Star Credit Union.
Suncoast takes on Krop tonight on the semifinal game of School Duel. To another exciting episode of School Duel, where close to 60 high schools from Miami-Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach counties competed to be part of the show. Now, our top 20 schools made it to the televised rounds, where they battle it out in an academic tournament for South Florida bragging rights. And the winners walk away with a school trophy from EDCO, a $1,000 check for each student courtesy of Bright Star Credit Union and Chick-fil-A. And continuing this season, each team here in the semifinals have qualified for the National Academic Championship. Now, details about this competition can be found online at qunlimited.com. So with that much at stake, let's go ahead and take a quick peek at the brackets for this week's game. As you see, the semifinal game features Suncoast High versus Dr. Michael Krop High in what is going to be an interesting showdown. Now, the winner between the two schools will be moving on to the championship game of School Duel 2016. So let's hear it for our two competitors. Yeah. I'm excited. Okay, but wait, there's more, because during the show, each student will compete in the Chick-fil-A Challenge. Here, the student with the most correct answers throughout the show will win Chick-fil-A chicken sandwiches for an entire year. Doesn't that sound enticing? All right, let's go ahead and get started. Our first round is called the warning shot. Here at School Against School, competing with toss-up questions directed at the entire group. Each question is worth 10 points, and if a question is answered incorrectly, then the other school gets one chance to steal the points. All right, schools, prepare for the warning shot. We'll begin with a question on birthplaces. Marco Polo was born in what Italian city famed for its canals? Tucker?
Venice.
Correct. All right, and we're off, ladies and gentlemen. Music, known for its lyrics that often promote social change, name this style of popular music made famous by Jamaican singers like Bob Marley. Jacob?
Reggae.
Yes, sir. Geometry. For a trapezoid, it's the perpendicular distance between the two bases. For a right circular cylinder, it's the distance between, Jacob?
Height.
Correct. Awesome. Economics. Give the term, starting with P, for the monthly income you might, yes, Noam?
Principal.
Incorrect. Suncoast, give the term, starting with P, for the monthly income you might receive after retiring from work. Jordan.
Pension.
Correct. All right, let's move on to authors. The novel of hers, published in 2015, is the original book she wrote before an editor. Karen?
Harper Lee.
Awesome job. All right, extinction. The ancient mastodon lived in what is now what very cold biome that Federico?
Pacific Ocean.
Incorrect. Suncoast. The ancient mastodon lived in what is now what very cold biome that never totally thaws? Karen?
The tundra.
Incorrect. It's the permafrost. All right, let's move on to the what am I question brought to you by the U.S. Army. This is where our contestants will be given a clue about something or someone and shown a picture that will slowly reveal itself. The first school to buzz in and answer correctly will, of course, get the points. So is everyone ready? Yes, here we go. Its common types include the bell version. Its multiple layers cover a female performer's body while still providing comfort for those who need to jump. Marison.
Tutu.
Tutu is correct. Good job. And a little tidbit, tutus originated in the 16th century in France and are made short to show off the ballerina's footwork. Moving along to food. The iceberg type of this food is also, Jordan?
Lettuce.
That's what we're talking about. Good job. All right, animal kingdom. Starting with the letter P, what do you call the division of the animal kingdom? That's, yes, Noam? All right, Suncoast, yes, Jacob.
Phylum.
Correct, good job. Moving along to government. Data from the most recent U.S. Census is always used to decide how many seats in what governing body, Noam?
House of Representatives.
Excellent. Epidemics. During the 1800s, epidemics of it hit New Orleans about once a decade until its source was identified. Karen.
Yellow fever.
Yes, that's what we're talking about. Moving along to the law. Give the legal term defined on the official U.S. court's website as a serious crime usually punished. Yes, Jacob?
Felony.
That's what it is, felony. You guys are good today. All right, authors. It's hard now to imagine that in his older years, he worked as a customs inspector in New York City and had trouble making a living at writing in spite of his 9 novels. Name this 19th century American author famous for the novel Moby Dick. Yes, Noam?
Herman Melville.
Yes. Phases. In science, give the term most commonly used for the phase change of gas changing to liquid. Yes, Jacob.
Sublimation.
Incorrect, Michael Krop. I'll finish the question. In science, give the term most commonly used for the phase change of gas changing to liquid, such as water vapor becoming dew. Yes, Marison.
Condensation.
Excellent. And that buzzer means the end to the warning shot round. We have Suncoast leading. They have 90 points. Dr. Michael Krop has 40 points. But don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with more School Duel after these messages. Make sure you download the School Duel app on your smartphone so you can keep up to date with everything School Duel right at your fingertips. School Duel app is available right now for all iPhone and Android users.
Improve your money skills with Brightstar University. At Brightstar University, people of all ages can log in to learn more about finances. Just choose your age-specific category and pick from a collection of interactive financial topics, including the Visa Financial Football Game, where your team scores by answering money management questions. Just go to www.brightstaru.com. Brightstar University is brought to you by Brightstar Credit Union, proud sponsor of School Duel on BECON-TV.
In 1973, Chick-fil-A founder Truett Cathy created the Leadership Scholarship Program,
encouraging Chick-fil-A restaurant employees to further their education.
Since then, Chick-fil-A has awarded more than $28 million in scholarships
to team members who excel in the classroom, serve their communities,
demonstrate a solid work ethic, and possess a desire to lead.
So we say, thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Truett. It means a lot.
Chick-fil-A is the proud corporate partner of the pursuit of higher education.
Beacon TV would like to thank the following sponsors for making School Duel possible.
Welcome back to School Duel. The first round of action ended with Suncoast leading. They have 90 points. Krop has 40 points. Now, before we begin the second round, let's take a minute to meet this week's competitors from each school. And we are going to start with the Suncoast Chargers. Welcome. Let's start with Jacob. He's a junior. Jacob, my question to you today is there a possible career field or career choice that you're looking into going into?
I'm not sure what branch yet, but I'd like to do something with computer science.
All right, sounds interesting. We'll keep us posted. We have Tucker, he's next to you. He's a senior, same question for you.
Something in either the tech or engineering fields, I think.
Okay, and Jordan, you're a senior. What's your career choice?
I would like to be an author.
Very nice. And last but not least, we have the captain of Suncoast team. Her name is Karen, and she's a junior. Karen, same question. What's your career choice or career field?
I guess I'd like to find work in the engineering field.
All right, sounds really nice. Now let's go ahead and meet their competitors. They are the Dr. Michael Krop Lightning. Welcome. Starting with Federico, he's a senior. And the same question to you, is there a career choice or career field you'd like to go into?
I think maybe journalism or mass communications.
Oh, you're speaking to my ears. I like it. All right, we have Marison, who's a senior. And your choice?
Environmental engineering.
All right, and Ben, you're a junior. What's your career choice?
Like a lot of people, engineering and computer science. I'm leaning towards programming.
Very nice, and that's actually not like a lot of people. That's unique, very unique. And the captain of Krop's team is Noam, who's a senior. Same question for you.
I'm not sure yet, but
possibly something to do with finance.
Very nice. All right, a nice group of individuals competing here today on School Duel. And now that we know everyone, let's go ahead and move into round two, the joust. Here, one player from each team competes head-to-head with a 10-point toss-up question. The player that wins then gets 3 bonus questions with their school worth 5, then 10, and then 15 points. All right, schools, it's that time. It is time to joust. Karen, Yom, come on down. Here's your toss-up question worth 10 points. In July 1969, this American astronaut became the first person to step, yes, Noam?
Neil Armstrong.
Yes, sir, good job. And we're with Dr. Michael Krop. The following bonus questions all deal with the moon. Bonus question number 1 is worth 5 points. The 11th edition of this American space program, Federico?
Apollo.
Yes. Bonus question number 2, this one's 10 points. Name the scientist who studied the moon with his telescope in 1610. Yes, Federico?
Galileo.
Yes. And your third bonus question is 15 points. Both the inner and outer core of the moon are made mostly of this element. The inner core is solid and the outer is liquid. Name the element. Marison.
Nickel.
No, we're looking for iron. All right, Ben and Jordan, it's your turn to joust, so come on down. Here's your toss-up question worth 10 points. Name this non-major sport with an annual Tour de France race. Yes, Jordan?
Biking.
Very good. Suncoast, here you go. The following bonus questions all deal with non-major sports, meaning no football, basketball, baseball, or hockey questions, okay? Bonus question number 1 is worth 5 points. What do you call the track and field competition with 10 individual events? Yes, Jacob?
Decathlon.
Excellent. Bonus question number 2 worth 10 points. Joey Logano won this major Florida, Tucker?
NASCAR.
No, I'm sorry, the answer is Daytona 500. Bonus question number 3 is worth 15 points. Originally played by Native Americans, what sport now? Yes, Tucker?
Lacrosse.
Excellent, very good. All right, Tucker and Marison, come on down. It's your turn to joust. Here's your toss-up question worth 10 points. Name this word that can mean an important part of your body or a musical instrument with multiple keyboards. Yes, Tucker?
Organ.
Yes. We're back with Suncoast. Here we go. The following bonus questions all deal with words with multiple meanings. First question is 5 points. Name this word that can mean a time period when you work or to move from first gear to second gear. Jordan.
Shift.
Yes. Bonus question number 2 is worth 10 points. Name this word that can mean to come from behind or an organized protest. Jacob.
Riot.
Incorrect. It's rally. And your third bonus question is 15 points. Name this word that can be related to speaking, but also is related to a wheel. Tucker.
Roll.
Oh, no. Spoke. No worries. Jacob, Federico, come on down. You are the last two to joust. Gentlemen, here's your toss-up question. It's worth 10 points, of course. Its new car, an RS7, has piloted... Yes, Federico? All right, Jacob, the question is yours. Its new car, an RS7, has piloted driving technology that lets it travel up to 140 miles per hour without a driver. Name this German car company whose slogan is Truth in Engineering and whose symbol is 4 interlocking rings. Yes, Jacob?
Audi.
Correct. All right, Suncoast. Your following bonus questions all deal with the symbols used by foreign car makers. Your first question is worth 5 points. What Italian sports car maker features a prancing horse? Yes, Jacob?
Ferrari.
Of course. And your second bonus question is 10 points. What South Korean maker's symbol shows its name inside an oval? Yes, Karen?
Hyundai.
Incorrect. It's a Kia. And your third bonus question is worth 15 points. What Japanese maker shows 3 diamonds in the shape of a shamrock because Tucker?
Mitsubishi.
Yes, excellent job. And my buzzer right there means the end to the joust round. We do have Suncoast holding on to their lead. They now have 165 points. Krop has 65 points. But again, don't go anywhere because we'll be right back with more School Duel just after these messages.
Yeah.
Make sure you download the School Duel app on your smartphone so you can keep up to date with everything School Duel right at your fingertips. The School Duel app is available right now for all iPhone and Android users.
We love magnet programs!
From elementary to high school, Broward County Public Schools magnet programs provide extra opportunities and experiences for students in specific fields of study. International Baccalaureate, Military Academy, Montessori, Performance and Visual Arts, Sciences, and many others. The programs are free. Shop early for your child's education. Apply online today at browardschools.com. Broward County Public Schools Magnet Programs.
Missing school? You're missing out. Regular attendance equals education, and education equals success.
Beacon TV would like to thank the following sponsors for making School Duel possible.
Welcome back to School Duel, where local high schools match wits to see who will be this year's School Duel champion. Now, this semifinal match has Suncoast High competing against Dr. Michael Krop High. Currently, Suncoast is leading. They have 165 points. Dr. Michael Krop has 65 points. We are now ready for the rapid-fire round. Now, during this round, the teams will receive a category of questions to answer within 60 seconds. Each question is worth 10 points, and if any questions are answered incorrectly, the other school will have the opportunity to steal the points. Now, since Krop is trailing, they have the opportunity to pick their category, and today's choices are Get Down with Brown or I See Red. So which category would you like, Dr. Michael Krop High?
Lisa will take I See Red.
Sounds good to me. All right, schools, here comes the rapid fire. Dr. Michael Krop, I See Red. In this category, the questions or answers all deal with the color or word red. Remember, you have 60 seconds to answer these questions worth 10 points each. So cue music and let's begin. Santa's red-nosed reindeer?
Rudolph.
It's known as the red planet.
Mars.
U.S.-based seafood restaurant chain.
Red Lobster.
Finish the Dr. Seuss title. One fish, two fish.
Red fish, blue fish.
Detroit hockey team.
Red Wings.
Popular energy drink.
Red Bull.
In the Old Testament, he parted the Red Sea.
Moses.
Under the bridge in Californication, ban.
Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Baseball team once known as the Big Red Machine.
Cincinnati Reds.
Publisher of a Lennox variant. All right, Krop, good job. You got through all of your questions. Let's see if Suncoast knows the answer to the only one you missed, and that is the publisher of a Lennox variant. That would be Red Hat. All righty, we're gonna move on now. Suncoast, your category is Get Down with Brown. In this category, the questions or answers all deal with the color or the word brown. Remember, you as well have only 60 seconds to answer these questions, which are worth 10 points each, so cue music and let's begin. Good grief, name that Peanuts character.
Charlie Brown.
City of football's Browns.
Cincinnati.
He directed Jackie Brown in Pulp Fiction.
Quentin Tarantino.
Ex-husband of Whitney Houston.
Never mind.
A Girl Scout between the ages of 6-9?
Brownie.
Its advertising slogan is, what can Brown do for you?
UPS.
Sings the duet No Air with Jordan Sparks.
Chris Brown.
Dr. Emmett Brown uses a DeLorean in this movie.
Back to the Future.
Author of the Da Vinci Code.
Dan Brown.
And Brown University is located in this state?
Rhode Island.
Excellent, you got through all of your questions, Suncoast. You only missed two? Michael Krop, let's see if you know the answer to this. City of football's Browns. Yes, Federico?
Cleveland.
Yes. And who's the ex-husband of Whitney Houston? That would be Bobby Brown. All right, there's the buzzer. That means the end of the rapid fire round. Suncoast is still leading. They have 245 points, but Dr. Michael Krop now has 165 points. But let's take a short break, and then we will be back for the final showdown to determine who moves on to the championship game of School Duel 2016. Make sure you download the School Duel app on your smartphone so you can keep up to date with everything School Duel right at your fingertips. The School Duel app is available right now for all iPhone and Android users.
In 1973, Chick-fil-A founder Truett Cathy created the Leadership Scholarship Program,
encouraging Chick-fil-A restaurant employees to further their education.
Since then, Chick-fil-A has awarded more than $28 million in scholarships
to team members who excel in the classroom, serve their communities,
demonstrate a solid work ethic, and possess a desire to lead.
So we say, thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Truett. It means a lot.
Chick-fil-A is the proud corporate partner of the Pursuit of Higher Education.
Improve your money skills with BrightStar University. At BrightStar University, people of all ages can log in to learn more about finances. Just choose your age-specific category and pick from a collection of interactive financial topics, including the Visa Financial Football Game, where your team scores by answering money management questions. Just go to www.brightstaru.com. BrightStar University is brought to you by BrightStar Credit Union, proud sponsor of School Duel on BECON-TV.
Beacon TV would like to thank the following sponsors for making School Duel possible.
Hello again, we are back with School Duel and we've got a good semifinal match going. Suncoast is holding on to their lead over Krop. Our current score is 245 to 165. It is now time for the final showdown. This is the last round. The schools will go against each other again with toss-up questions, but this time these questions are now worth 20 points each. Now remember, if a question is answered incorrectly, the other school can steal the points. All right, schools, this is for a spot in the championship game. It is time for the final showdown. Your first question deals with blood. Which type of blood vessel carries oxygenated blood from your heart to your extremities, Karen?
Arteries.
Native Americans, when gold was found in Georgia near its lands, they were relocated along what is now, Karen?
The Trail of Oklahoma.
Incorrect. Krop, Nome?
Trail of Tears.
Incorrect. We were looking for the tribe of Native Americans and its Cherokee. Novels. Name the Ray Bradbury story that gets its name from the temperature at which paper, Jordan?
Fahrenheit 451.
Texas. The Riverwalk and the Alamo are both landmarks in what Texas city? Federico.
San Antonio.
Fast capitals. What is the capital of Nepal? Marison. Suncoast? Karen.
Kathmandu.
Spanish. Give the four-letter word for the Spanish dessert made of custard with caramel syrup. Yes, Federico?
Flan.
Politics. He survived a recall election in 2012 and ran, Noam?
Scott Walker.
Epics. The great Russian author Leo Tolstoy wrote this very long novel, Ben?
War and Peace.
States. Name the U.S. state that contains both Myrtle Beach and Hilton Head Island. Noam?
South Carolina.
Major League Baseball. Justin Verlander and Miguel Cabrera are stars, Noam?
The Tigers.
Art, name this artistic technique used to paint the ceilings of the Sistine Chapel. Karen?
Mural.
Incorrect. Krop, name this artistic technique used to paint the ceilings of the Sistine Chapel in which paint is placed directly on damp or wet plaster. That's called fresco. Reality TV. The father of this family spent 4 years in the Arkansas State Legislature and wrote a book with his wife that is subtitled 20 and Counting. Give the last name of this family whose reality show, Jordan?
Duggar.
Music. Which musical note is represented in the treble clef by the third space from the bottom? Jacob?
B.
Incorrect. Krop? Ben?
C.
Same names. Which variety of tomato plant shares its two-word name with a variety of green apple that is often used in apple pie? Federico?
Granny Smith.
Grammy winners. At age 12, she appeared on radio in her native New Zealand. Less than 5 years later, yes, Tucker?
Lord.
International companies. It recently began regular 15 and a half hour nonstop flights from Sydney to the U.S. Name this, Tucker?
Qantas.
Viruses. A new study pinpoints the origins of its pandemic around 1920. Name this virus transmitted mostly through, Marison?
Spanish flu.
Incorrect. Suncoast, named this virus transmitted mostly through sexual contact and drug use that causes AIDS. Karen.
HIV.
Physics. In physics, what law says that voltage is current times resistance? Tucker.
Ohm's law.
parts. Developed in the late 1950s, as cars became faster, its first versions were considered 2-point. For adults, it commonly has 3 points. 2 across the lap. Tucker?
Seatbelt.
World War II, the American military cemetery in Manila with more than 17,000 dead from World War II is located in what Asian island? Nome?
Philippines.
Construction. The material gypsum is often used to make what substance hung on walls and paint? Yes, Tucker?
Drywall.
Fictional characters. What fictional character lived with his uncle Vernon, his aunt Petunia? Nome?
Harry Potter.
There's my buzzer, and that brings an end to this quarterfinal school duel match. And Suncoast held on tightly to their lead throughout the show, going on to winning with a score of 445 points. But Krop did an excellent job. They are ending with 365 points. Now, Suncoast, you know what this win means? That you are going to the championship game. Congratulations! But of course, great job to everyone. Now, this also brings an end to the Chick-fil-A challenge. And today's winner is, drum roll, please. We have a tie, Tucker and Noam, congratulations. All right, gentlemen, congratulations on your Chick-fil-A chicken sandwiches for an entire year. Now, at this time, we want to thank you at home for watching, of course, so thank you. And a big thank you to all of our sponsors for making School Duel possible. Now, don't forget to check out our website at schoolduel.tv, where you can find out even more about all of the schools involved this year, as well as vote on who you thought was the player of the week for today's game. And of course, use hashtag School Duel to contact us through social media. But most importantly, make sure that you tune in next week to School Duel Thursday at 7 p.m. as tonight's winner, Suncoast High, takes on Cooper City High in the championship game of School Duel 2016. Goodbye, everyone. Thanks for watching.
School Duel was brought to you by Chick-fil-A and Bright Star Credit Union.
Make sure you download the School Duel app on your smartphone so you can keep up to date with everything School Duel right at your fingertips. The School Duel app is available right now for all iPhone and Android users.